What is up, my dude and dudettes, and welcome back to TellerTube. In today's video, we're going to be looking at some more r/choosingbeggars. But first, apparently 75% of you guys are not subscribed to the channel, so if you guys could do me a huge favor and subscribe to the channel if you want me to continue to make these videos for you guys. And with that being said, sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. Just another toxic relationship story. So the story is from a little under a year ago now. I sort of understand the stress that led to the situation, and I don't bear the choosing beggar much ill will. But it and a good few other similar incidences informed my decision to end the relationship about 6 months ago. So this story, I suppose obviously, regards my ex. Back when we started dating, she was studying for her undergraduate degree at university. She was very bright and very interested in her degree, but she wasn't a great writer and really struggled when it came to managing her time and resources for writing assignments. I found this out when one day, a few months into our relationship, we were both visiting her parents for a few days away from the big city. I was chilling out in a different room and letting her get some work done. I knew she had a big assignment due at midday the next day, so I was making sure not to distract her, giving her space to work so she could get it all done and in on time. She comes bursting into the room, in tears, panicked, and scared because she cannot get it all finished. She's already significantly over the word limit and has not even come close to finishing her argument yet. Now, I was kind of used to these kind of situations. I was a couple years older and had finished a law degree already, so last minute buckle down essay editing was pretty standard stuff for me. I gave her a hug, wiped her tears, made her a cup of tea, and told her we were going to sort this out. Over the next 8 hours or so, we worked as a unit. She wrote new content and built her arguments while I scored the rest of her essay, cutting down unnecessary words while making sure that the meaning remained intact, incorporating her new content as I went. It took us all night, but we pulled that essay into shape and we got it in on time, fully completed and exactly one word under the maximum word count. She got a first, the highest grade you can get in the British university system. This was actually a high point for our relationship. At the time, she was very grateful, very happy, and I felt very appreciated. We had made a great team. As time went on, however, I came to find out that she was behind on essays more and more frequently. I would find myself rushing across the city at a moment's notice to fix up another paper which was going to be in late again and again. It started to get a little tiring, as it was obvious that I was being used as a crutch to compensate for her poor time management, and began to feel that I was being taken for granted. I think even she realized this because when it came to her final dissertation, she told me that she did not want any help. She was going to do it all on her own. I was kind of proud of her for this. She seemed to be really buckling down, getting stuck into it, and was doing the bulk of the work with plenty of time left. It all seemed to be going well. In the final weeks of her project, I checked in a few times to see if she needed anything, but she was adamant that everything was fine without my input. That is, until one morning, I got an urgent text from her demanding I come over immediately. Sorry for the excessively long backstory, but here is where the actual choosing beggar story begins. She tells me that she needs me over to help with her dissertation as it has to be in by 2 p.m. and she is nowhere near finished with it yet. This panics me because I know I can fix up an essay in a few hours and make it acceptable, but working over a complete dissertation would be a genuine nightmare on such a time crunch. I write back that I thought she still had a few days to get it done and asked if she had the date wrong. She responds that no, it is not due for a couple of days and I start to relax. I tell her that I can be over in the afternoon to help out for the rest of the day and probably all of tomorrow as well, but that I have to get some work done myself and that I'll need to go to the gym on my way back to hers. That may sound kind of petty, but I had been using frequent exercise at the gym as a means of managing a pretty bad depression spiral for a while. It was the only thing to have worked so far, so my gym sessions had become very important to me, even if I wasn't getting overly muscular from them. She knew why this was so important to me at the time. She did not like this though. She goes from 0 to 100 very quickly and starts chewing me out for not putting her first and doing my silly little gym thing another day. She tells me that she decided that she wanted this submitted by 2 p.m. today a while ago and that we have to stick to that timeline. I for a moment put aside the fact that I had asked her literally the night before if she would need any help, and got an emphatic no and simply responded that I need to get this workout done to stay on my program and that it is very important to me, but that I would happily come over after and work late into the night on her project, which would still leave us finished about 36 hours before the deadline. This just angers her further. She says that she doesn't want me to do that thing you do, where I try to negotiate a fair middle ground instead of raising my voice or getting into an argument. She says that this is too important to her to have to compromise on it. This goes on for a while, but through all the anger and demanding, I can see that she seems genuinely scared, like she was that first night at her parents' place. Just a terrified student feeling in over her head in need of a little help. So, I swallow my pride, put my needs aside, and tell her I'll be there in an hour. We live in a big city. That's the time it would take for me to get there if I left immediately. The whole ride there, I feel a weird mix of anger, sadness, and confusion. But when I get to the door, she opens it kind of timidly and gives me this kind of sheepish smile. All the anger evaporates as this just confirms to me that she was only scared and lashing out. Not ideal, but understandable. I once again give her a hug, make her a cup of tea, and we set to work. It's a harrowing ordeal. The paper is content complete and it is thousands of words over the limit and riddled with grammatical and spelling errors. I worked nonstop at it till late in the evening. We were never going to make it by 2 p.m. But with a lot of hard work, it was finally finished. With everything put in its right place, it was actually a very thoughtful and interesting project. I give it one last read over, smile, and hand the laptop back to her for her approval. She snatches it off of me with a kind of huff sound as her attitude changes immediately. Over the next minute or so, she confirms that the work is done, checks that it's all ready to go, and then closes the laptop and immediately launches into an argument with me about how I should have came over immediately without being so difficult about it. I'm stunned. It slowly begins to dawn on me that she wasn't scared or sheepish or anything of the sort when I arrived at the door. She was playing nice, so I would do her work for her, and the second she had gotten what she wanted, she moved on to admonishing me for not being immediately available to her. For an arbitrary deadline she had set for herself. I tried to reason with her briefly, but she wasn't having none of it and just wanted to yell. Eventually, she made what I think was a bluffing suggestion that I should just go home, and I accepted the offer and left. It was late, and I was now crossing a dangerous city in complete darkness, sad and confused. I never did make it to the gym that day. Over the next few days, she didn't speak to me much and was still angry at my initial resistance. Eventually, we got past this and we dated for another 6 months at least. This incident really opened my eyes to the kind of person she was though, and over the last few months, I noticed more and more how unequal the dynamic between us had become. It all came to a head last November with yet another incident kind of like this. Oh my goodness. Come on, Karen, your boyfriend is going out of his way to help you with your projects, and you're not even a little bit grateful.
Oh my goodness, you should have been here like an hour ago. What are you thinking? Now get to work.
Shake my head. Mother refused free drink at amusement park for nothing. So this happened yesterday at our local amusement park. I was going to get a refill on our drink cups when a Karen came waving a receipt. Both the refill station guy and I looked puzzled, so I let her go in front of me. I had a feeling this was going to get nuts, and I wanted a front row seat. DG is drink guy, K is Karen. Karen,
I'm here to get my free refill. As you can see, I bought a cup.
Drink guy, that's fine, where's your cup?
I lost it, but I have the receipt right here, so give me a new cup.
Ma'am, I'm sorry, but we are not responsible if you lose your cup. I can give you a small soda, but I can't give you a new cup.
A small soda? This is baloney. I paid for a reusable cup and I demand a new one.
At this point, I see a boy around 13 or 14 come walking up. I'm thinking it's just a kid who is getting a fresh drink. Boy, was I wrong.
This kid said, Mom, did you want some more?
The drink guy looked at the receipt and asked how many cups did she get. She said only one. My park has two colored cups for refill cups. For a single day, you get a green, and for a full year, it's orange. The receipt said one single day refill cup, and what does her son have? A green cup. Drink guy, excuse me kid, did your mom get you that cup? Karen turns red face and pushes her son out of the line and tries to hide in a passing school group. I just look at my mom and said, see, that is what we call a Karen. Oh my goodness. So Karen just tried to finesse a free cup. Oh, you lost your cup, eh Karen? Then what's that cup in your son's hand? Donkey. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, smash that like button as it would really help me out. Subscribe to my channel so you can stay up to date with my latest videos, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.